before. And Father God, we just thank you, Lord. Father God, Lord, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. Use me, oh Lord, in your service. Father God, it's not about me, it's all about you. Father God, I'm just so empty picture before I ask, Lord, how's this? Father God, use me, Lord. Father God, I'm asking to God to help me to be able to do the things that you have assigned me to do, dear God. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for your grace and your mercy. Father God, we love you, we magnify your holy name. Father God, just thank you, God. Father God, thank you for the mess, oh Lord, that you have given me, dear God. And Father God, just thank you, oh God, we just thank you. I just can't say enough. Thank you, dear God. Help us, oh Lord. Help us, Lord. Father God, we understand that you're the balm in Gilead. You're the healing balm in Gilead. Father God, you got all power in your holy hand. Father God, we thank you. Do you think we ask in your Son Jesus' name? Amen. What we have for our thought today, I would like to give honor to my pastor, to my husband, to all the deacon ministers, to the mother ministers, which are called deaconess, to our choir, the usher, and all of you that makes up this congregation, all God's children. It is a blessing to be in the house of the Lord one more time. And this is a great opportunity to be able to bring forth his word. While I was thinking about this Mother's Day, but let me give you where I'm coming from here. I'm coming out of the book of Ruth. And Ruth, the first chapter. 1-9, and it reads as following. It said, "Now it came to pass in the days when Judge Ruth, that there was a famine in the land, and a certain man of Bethlehem went down to sojourn to the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons. And the name of the man was Emily, and the name of his wife was Naomi, and the name of his two sons, Mahlon and Chilion, the Ephrathites of the Bethlehem Judea, and they came into the country of Moab and continued there." And let me skip to the 9th verse. "The Lord grant you that you may find rest, each of you, in the house of her husband." Then she kissed them, and they lift up their voice and wept. And I'm going to you for thought today, handling life famine with success, and the girl who chose God.
All right.
This is a book that I have studied. And as I was studying, I thought about different things in life, where I grew up from, where I came from, and so forth. One thing, since it's Mother's Day, one thing about my mom was a very hard-working woman. She was a character. She enjoyed people. She made you laugh. She made you cry. But one day my mama did say, my mama talked a whole lot. There was something that she said I didn't believe her. But as I got older, I thought my mama was just talking. But everything that my mom said to me came to pass.
All right.
Whatever she was saying about whoever it was, she said, "Barbara, you watch it. It gone up." And sure enough, it come to pass. And And sometimes that I feel that I have picked up some of that trait. If I stay around you long enough, I'm going to know something. Because therefore, the Holy Ghost just going to reveal something to me about you. There are some things I may not can express it to you, may not can tell you. But when that time is right for me to say the old thing, I will say it. So that's just it. I do have some of her traits. The older I get, they say I favor. So that's about it. Like I say that, back in the day, they were dealing with the famous and different stuff going on with money and so forth and so on. But I can tell you all this. My dad could not read and write, but he could shoot a gun.
All right.
One thing about dad would go hunting. I'm gonna tell y'all, I have eaten everything that you can name of. Rabbits, squirrel, coon, possum, alligator, bear. Well, you know I had chicken and hog and beef and turkey and duck and all of that, all the different game. And I might have had some buffalo and some moose. I don't know what all I did have. My mama was the type of woman that she didn't work too much in the field. But she was mostly work in the white people houses. She babysitter, she cleaned up, she did it all. So there were a lot of that meat that we received came from them. But now, whether she knew how to cook it or not, she cooked it.
All right.
And so therefore, we ate.
All right.
I will not, people say, well, I can't eat this and can't eat that. Oh, wait a minute. If it's just a certain kind of food on the land, I think I still will survive.
All right.
Because I can eat anything.
All right.
Just about anything. All that I'm not allergic to, I can eat. Because one thing about it, I'm going to eat. I'm going to survive. That's just the bottom line. But I thank God for Jesus. But what I'm speaking about here, he said that Samuel had been suggested to be the author of this book. But if I want to sum this book up in 10 words or less, I would say, lawyer, daughter-in-law, picture God, faithfulness, love, and care. Now, he said, it came to pass in the day of the judges that there was a famine in the land.
Yes, Lord.
In the land of Israel.
Uh-huh.
In the little town called Bethlehem in Judea, there lived a man by the name of Elimelech.
Right.
His wife and his two boys, Madeline and Shalom, since the famine was so bad, Elimelech decided that he would take his family up and move to Moab.
Yes.
There they found out there was enough food to eat there.
Uh-huh.
But it was not long till Emily's died.
Yes.
And Naomi was left with her two sons.
Uh-huh.
Now God planned that.
Yes, sir.
He had already planned.
Yes, it was.
In about 10 years, the boys grew up and they both married women of Moab.
Uh-huh.
Shalom married Orpah. Malon married Ruth.
Uh-huh.
Both Shalon and Malon died.
Yeah, yeah.
And Naomi was left with no one but her two daughters-in-law.
Yeah.
She heard that there was plenty of food in the land of Judea.
Uh-huh.
And she said to her daughter-in-law, I'm going back home.
Yeah.
So she started, and Orpah and Ruth started with her.
Uh-huh.
But they had gone far to north. Naomi thought of the future. She said to them, now it's goodbye. That's what she thought. Return to your people.
Uh-huh.
Return to your people.
Uh-huh.
And marry them.
Yes, yes.
She also blessed her.
Uh-huh.
She told her, because I'm an old lady. 48, I'm having more children and all. And I know that you all are not going to wait around on me to have some more babies.
Have mercy.
So therefore, you move back, go back.
Uh-huh.
Now, Madeline and Shelon, our name means sick and pendant, respectively. The girl both wept when she told me to go back.
Uh-huh.
Ophrah, she turned back, but her name means stuck.
Uh-huh.
Ruth clung to Naomi and she said, urge me not to leave.
Yeah.
For whatever you go, I go.
I go. Yes, sir.
Wherever you stay, I stay.
Yes, sir.
Your people be my people, and your God will be my God.
Yeah.
Whatever you die, I will die. And there I'll be buried. The Lord be my witness that even death shall not part you and me.
Have mercy.
Now Ruth's name means friendship. Naomi's name means blessing.
Uh-huh.
Ruth, a Gentile girl, woman, married to a Jewish family.
All right.
When all of the men of the family died, Ruth showed loyalty to her mother-in-law.
Yes, she did.
Naomi stayed with her, scouting food for wherever she can get it from to keep them alive.
Yes.
And Ruth gleaned the barley in the field of this wealthy Boaz.
Uh-huh.
He took interest in her
and
ordered her to be watched over.
Uh-huh.
The reason why he did that, because if she had a went over into another field of some kind, he wasn't sure whether they were going to treat her right.
Yes,
because
yes.
She was, in so much, so many words, she was what they call a farmer.
Uh-huh.
So they probably would have treated her wrongly.
Speak.
Naomi recognized Boaz as her late husband relative and encouraged Ruth to pursue him as a kinsman redeemer.
Yes.
One who wed relative with us continue a family line.
Uh-huh.
Boaz married Ruth,
uh-huh.
starting to notice the span. That's what our God does for us.
Uh-huh.
He worked things out so that we can be redeemed. He put us in a situation that we, one way or the other, do everything.
Yes.
We can trust God to provide what we need, when we need it, and to work out our life in a way that is better than we can imagine.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
One can only have been alive on the last past years to experience a family.
All right.
A life family.
Uh-huh.
You ask, what is a family?
Mm-hmm.
A family is when that which is important to you for survival is taken away.
All right.
When your resources have been wiped out, when you are facing a life thing. When that man or that woman who used to say that he or she didn't want to live with you have decided now I can't live without you.
All right, well.
That's a life thing. When you are that particular job that you were holding and paying good money or whatever the situation may be, decide to downsize and lay you off, leaving you wondering how you were going to make a mortgage payment, how you going to take care of that dream home you had, or pay your rent. That is a life thing.
Yes, it is.
But the word said, don't throw in the towel.
Uh-huh.
God just may be setting you up for a comeback.
Yeah.
But you are facing a life thing.
Yeah.
And I brought good news for you today from today, mother, from the word of Ruth.
All right.
Ruth showed up that there is a sovereign, that our God is sovereign, he's all God.
Yes, he is.
She showed up how to handle life failing with success.
Yes.
She made it clear that our real resources never lie with any material stuff.
Have mercy.
And those resources are nothing more than what they are called resources.
Resource. Yes.
Re means they come from out of, but they are not the original.
All right.
The lesson is that material things in this world are only a byproduct of the source.
Yeah.
They are a result of the real source.
Yeah.
The Lord, which is the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Psalm 121 says, I looked unto the hill which covered my head. And all my help come from the Lord. A favor bring about a change in our life.
Yes, it does.
A favor also deal with, life come with a test.
Uh-huh.
The way you handle the test will determine the quality of the living.
Yeah.
We attach God's name to our praying without his approval. The devil send you temptation to defeat you. God send you tests to develop.
Yes.
Trust God right and face the test.
Yes.
Life comes with trust.
Uh-huh.
There's always a favor in the land where there is no God in your life.
Have mercy.
If you don't have Christ in your life, you look for a favor. You look for a handicap. You look for whatever situation there is in your life if you don't have Christ in your
life.
You need to know the resources. You need to know the sources of your trouble.
Uh-huh.
When you make sense out of your trouble, it don't seem to hurt as bad. Understanding your sources of trouble is what puts you in the right direction to move through the bitterness and place blame that being broken. Now, Naomi was considered bitter when God took her man from her.
That's right.
So she became bitter.
Uh-huh.
She said he had dealt bitter with her, and she just went on with everything, the moping and the situation of her family. It is when you become broken that God will develop you. Often God has to break us in order that we become better.
Yes.
Moving and don't look back at your trouble is what Luke did.
All right.
Life comes with transformation.
Yes, it does.
Transforming your focus from bad to better will set you up for God's kingdom.
Yes, Lord.
You have to answer the question, did that which I went through cause me to be bitter or better?
Have mercy.
Bitter or better?
All right.
The answer to the question, God was not trying to make you bitter.
Uh-huh.
God was trying to make you better. When you have been transformed into what God wants you to be, to do in your life, you will have a God finish.
All right.
Ruth and Naomi was set up for God finish. It wasn't complete until God, it wasn't complete, but God was working.
Yeah.
Just to know what God is working will give you strength to make it. That's what Boaz's name means.
Strength.
He's just that kind of God.
Yeah.
Some of you can say that you're going through a lot right now, but you ought to be able to thank God for the common attraction.
Yeah.
Your God finished. You can say can you say that you are better now, or can you handle life finally with success? If there is anybody here who has been set up by God finished, my sister and brother, and the word of God is great enough for all of us to go tell somebody that Jesus Christ is alive and great.
Yeah.
That he lives within us.
Uh-huh.
Tell them that the fight is over. Come on in and dine with him.
Yeah.
Thank God for waking us up this morning, starting us on our way, and giving us a mind to do his will.
Uh-huh.
Ruth went out empty, but she came back laughing with blessing and beaming with joy.
Yeah.
So much so that Naomi was constrained to say, where have thou been today?
Yeah.
The secret of her success lay in this man.
Uh-huh.
She had been with a mighty man of wealth, like Christ, Boaz, a wealth of possession, a wealth of influence, a wealth of grace.
Yeah.
She had been with the nearest kin.
Uh-huh.
She knew not of the relationship, but he did.
Yeah.
The kinman had the right to avenge or to redeem.
Yeah.
Our kinman, redeemer, came to condemn, not to condemn, but to give life a ransom for us.
Yes, he did.
And let me talk a little bit right here.
Uh-huh.
Boaz knew that Naomi had a closer kin than him.
Uh-huh.
But when Ruth did everything that her mother-in-law told her to do, told her to go in and clean herself up, dine, and go in and Wait till they have this little feast, a little party, whatever. She knew that Boaz was going to come in sooner or later and lie down. So Naomi had told her what to do and how to do it. She told her to go in and clean herself up, get herself all smelling good and so forth and so on, and said for her to go back there and wait. Because Ruth really didn't know. She wanted to make sure that she knew who Boaz was at a particular time. So therefore she waited until he came to wherever they were all laying at, so that she could go to the right man. So therefore, what she did when he lied down to sleep or whatever it was, she laid at his feet. When she laid at his feet, she pulled the cover off his feet. She pulled the cover off his feet so that he can get some air. The air will blow on his feet that he will wake up.
All right.
That's what it was all about. So therefore, he was some kind of symbolizing and letting them know that I want to be with you.
And
so many words to make another way to say it. But she did as her mother-in-law told her to do.
All right.
When Boaz realized who Naomi or who Ruth was, she scared him at first. He wanted to know, what is this woman in here? Who is this in the bedroom? So therefore, when he realized who it was, as she explained herself, he decided to make haste and go find the nearest kin.
Have mercy.
He went to the nearest kin and let him know what the situation was and everything, because he knew what was what, that she was considered being a redeemer. She wanted him as a redeemer for the next kin. And the guy he went to, the closer kin, he went to him to tell him to redeem. He said, okay. But when he told him that you would have to marry this woman, he said, oh no, I already got a wife. I can't do that. So you the next in line. God, that was a God pinch. He set that up so that this guy would be able to let them know that I can't do it, you do it. And that's all Boaz wanted to
hear.
So he made haste to do what he had to do. He said that she had been with one who was not ashamed to acknowledge her public.
Have mercy.
She sat beside his reaper, and he reached her parched corn. He gave her a time of refreshing from his own presence.
Have mercy.
Ruth never said no to the gift of grace.
Have mercy.
That's what Jesus does for us. Jesus always give us time. He shake us, he get on us about whatever. But he give you time to come back in.
Have mercy.
You get out, he give you time, he allow you to go through things in your life, the favor in your life for you to come back in.
Have mercy.
He's not gonna rush in. But if you so wants to be so hard, he do a lot of things to happen that you can't see.
Have mercy.
So he's saying that Jesus, he gave us time to accept him as his personal, as our personal Savior. She had been with the one who planned for good. His eye was all over the field and all ready to do his bidding. So handful of was dropped on purpose according to his will. We are blessed indeed when we come in touch with the unsearchable Christ.
Have mercy.
It is his purpose, not ours. Boaz is extremely wealthy. He was off the tribe of Judea and in the direct line of the Messiah.
All right.
His name means in him is strength. Boaz and Ruth are very noticeable in the scriptures simply because they both in the line of the Messiah.
Yeah, Lord.
Boaz is direct lineage. Ruth is married, therefore, uniting the Jews and the Gentiles together. Chapter 4 and 1 and verse 1 through 22 say, God's divine plan for the blossom of Boaz redeemed Naomi, land and Ruth, land and man. Naomi once was empty, now she's full.
Yeah.
Ruth was once a widow, and now she's married.
Uh-huh.
Most importantly, the Lord had prepared the Christ line of the descendant in David through Boaz and Obed back to the Jews.
Have mercy.
To Judas to fulfill the proper messianic lineage. My sisters and brothers, that is why Jesus went to the cross.
Tell us.
So he went to hell to make sure that we have success in the time of famine.
Have mercy.
Jesus came through the world through 42 generations to redeem mother like Naomi and Ruth.
All right.
Jesus died on the old rugged cross for your sin and mine. He said no. He said, no man, take my life, I lay it down.
Lay it down.
He hanged his head in the locks of his sin, and he died, and he gave up the ghost.
Yes,
they spilled him in the sign, and out came blood and water. Blood for redemption and water for baptism.
Yes.
Between the ninth and the sixth hour, they took my Lord and your God down and buried him in another man's tomb. Joseph knew tomb. He stayed there in the grave 3 days and 3 nights. But early the first day of the week, he arose from that grave with his son. He arose from the grave with all power in his holy hand by his Father.
Have mercy.
After so many days, or 40 days of being seen by different ones, he told the disciples, I am going away back to the Father.
Yes, sir.
I will leave your comforter, which is considered the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
He called a cloud back to heaven. Someone said, why are you men standing and gazing up? The same way you see him leave is the same way he will return. For a church without a spot of blame, will you be ready? I heard a song say, whatever you need, mother, God got it.
All right.
If in love, God got it. If it's bread, God got it. If it's peace, God got it. If it's joy divine, God got it. This is the message. Happy Mother Day. The doors of God's house is open. You can come by letter, a candidate for baptism, or by